Hello everyone. September was a relatively good month for risky assets. And in contrast, it was more difficult for government bonds and those assets whose valuations are vulnerable to rises in long-term interest rates. Now, one of the factors behind the solid performance of US equity markets in September was a revival in hopes for Trumpflation. Trumpflation, you'll remember, was much touted in the wake of last November's US presidential election. The idea is that President Trump, by embarking on the implementation of wide-ranging stimulus measures, would trigger a pickup in economic growth and inflation. This would then be good for equity markets and bad for bond markets. So President Trump's recent announcements of major tax cuts for households and companies again raises the prospect of Trumpflation. We think it's likely that these tax measures will be voted through Congress, particularly as the Republican Party is in desperate need of a congressional victory before going to the midterm elections in November 2018. In terms of government bonds, the US Treasury bond market was also negatively impacted by speculation about the Federal Reserve's future monetary policy. It wasn't so much the confirmation that the widely expected reduction in the Federal Reserve's balance sheet will begin this October that weighed on the bond market, as very specific comments from Janet Yellen about the prospect of future increases in key interest rates. Nonetheless, despite its recent rise, the yield of a US 10-year Treasury note remains lower than it was at the beginning of 2017. There's a more detailed article about September's equity market trends and a number of pieces of analysis from our experts on our blog, Investors Corner. Thank you for listening and see you again soon.